So how do we extend the independence story to more than two variables? Well, the strongest way we can do it is by something called mutual independence. We'll say that three random variables x, y, and z are mutually independent if we can write the joint distribution, that is, the distribution for all three of them, as simply the product of the three individual distributions. So if it's just px times py times pz, then we say that they're mutually independent. And this is the strongest independence statement we can make, because this says x and y, knowing x and y won't tell you anything about z. Knowing x won't tell you anything about y. So this is the strongest statement we can make. It says they're completely independent, all separate. But there are also weaker forms of independence that we're interested in. For example, pairwise independence. And pairwise independence means that for any two variables, you can write pxy is equal to px times py. And similarly for yz and xz. So this is saying if I know any one, it doesn't tell me anything about any of the others. This is not the same as mutual independence. It's not as strong. And let's talk about an example of why. So let's suppose that we have two random variables, x and y. And they both represent independent fair coin flips. And we'll write the outcomes as 0 and 1. So tails corresponds to 0, heads corresponds to 1. And each one has a 50-50 chance of being heads or tails, 0 or 1. And we'll define z as x, x or y. So xor is defined to be a function that takes in two things and returns 1 when exactly one of them is 1. So let's draw out a table to make that a little more clear. So let's write x values, y values, and z values, and the corresponding probabilities in pxy. We'll keep those on this side. So if x and y are 0, 1 coin flips, they can take on 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, or 1, 1. Now, if they're both 0, then xor is also 0. But if exactly one of them is 1 in these two cases, z will be 1. And if they're both 1, z will just be 0. Now, what's the probability pxy for each of these configurations? Well, I told you that they're independent fair coin flips. So every one is equally likely. The probability of any particular one is 0.5 for x times 0.5 for y. So it's 0.25, 0.25, 0.25, and 0.25. Now, what's the distribution for z? Well, what's the probability that z is 0? Well, there are two ways to get it. There's this one and this one. And they each have probability 0.25. So if we add them up, then we have a 0.5 chance of being 0 and a 0.5 chance of being 1. And we can then say that, well, what's the probability of z given x? We want to test maybe whether z and x are independent. Well, it's actually the same as this. Because if we look, if x is 0, then we can restrict ourselves to just looking at this. And if x is 1, we can restrict ourselves to just looking at this. And if x is 0, Well, z can either be 0 or 1, and they're equally likely, so it's 50-50. And if x is 1, again, they're equally likely. There's 1, 0, and they're 50-50. So in this case, it would be the same. So it doesn't depend on x at all. It's completely independent of x. So this means that we can write that z and x are independent. And by symmetry, we can make the same argument for y. And I told you from the start that x and y are independent. So we can say x independent of y. So here we have three random variables that are all pairwise independent. That is, if you look at any pair, knowing one doesn't tell you about any one other. But if we look all together, they're not mutually independent. For example, if I know any two of them, then I know exactly what the third one is going to be. The distribution over the third one changes from being fair 50-50 to being deterministic. For example, if x is 0 and y is 0, then z is also going to be 0. And if I didn't know that, then the probability would be 50-50. But once I do know that, the probability becomes 1 that it's 0 and 0 that it's anything else. So here, they're not mutually independent. And in general, in this example, it may seem a little contrived, but in general, it's often tempting to assume that knowing things are pairwise independent tells you that they're mutually independent, but you have to be aware that they're not.